But then, don't we think that India is in itself a very rich country, a very rich in diversity, rich in so much of culture that we can take so much from ancient civilizations? Do we really need to adopt the Western culture? That is the question. A small story from Swamiji's life. He was in America to attend the World Parliamentary Youth World Parliament of Religions. He had already become very popular internationally by then. Yet he was worried. You know why he was worried? He was worried about the poor people in India. He was worried about the state of affairs in the country back then. He was given a bed, a very comfortable bed to sleep. And that night, he did not sleep. He preferred sleeping on the floor. This is because he thought of the nation. How many of us in this modern day think of this kind of values? Swamiji had called upon the youth of our country to protect the people. We are not able to protect our own citizens. The citizens of our country are being molested. The women, they are molested, physically abused. Every day we see that in the newspapers. If we are not able to protect our own citizens, my friends, how do we feel we are going to protect ourselves from our enemies? Is that the value that is inculcated in us? I would like to conclude. Power will come, glory will come, goodness will come, purity will also come, and all that is important will come. But we need to wake up from the sleeping soul. So it is important to arise, awaken, and we should not stop till our goal is reached. So, and that can only be done if we adopt ancient values. Thank you so much.
Very well said, Akash. Another forceful presentation. So what is the use of science and technology without ancient values? How can we solve the modern problems which are affecting our daily life without the support of ancient values? And Akash has put forth one or two examples from Swamiji's life, how he was an embodiment of values though he went to the West, how he represented the country in his personality. Good thoughts by young Akash from Hyderabad. We appreciate his presentation and look forward for other thoughts also. Now we'll come to the next speaker, who will be debating on modern values that is important to become a good citizen. Let us listen to Shravan Kumar from Hyderabad.
Good afternoon, one and all. It's a very important topic that we are discussing today, whether ancient values are important or modern values. Here, I like to emphasize that modern values are very important for us today. As one of our friends pointed out, today we are living in a modern world. So we need a modern values to be followed. I'll tell you why. I will just give an example. Now we are shooting all the program here in high definition cameras. Now, tomorrow, if you want to see the same program again, we can play on this CDs and watch it again. What if we have been in ancient time or ancient times where we have only old system models where we can have only 5 to 6 minutes recording and we have old devices or old type of players, we cannot see all this thing. So we have modernized ourselves so that we can have everything to our need. In the same way, for the newer generations, for the modern generations, we need to have modern values for betterment. And there was a, as the debate is going on, I was thinking, what are these special modern values? Is there any difference between ancient values and modern values? I'll just try to present you a small view of that modern values. Once there were Vedas, every Bhagavad Gita, everything was composed in a single line and they are taught only to Brahmins. When it comes to Shankaracharya, he separated them. He brought out Bhagavad Gita separately, he brought out Upanishad separated. But when it comes to Vivekananda, he has condensed them again still and brought us into our regular use in form of quotations and his teachings. Is it not that ancient values have been just modernized for our understanding? In the same way, the modern values are nothing but the condensation or brought down for the understanding level of ancient values. We see when a small child was fed by a mother, she crushes all the food into a small morsel so that the baby can digest it very easily. In the same way, these modern values are the digest or the simple form of the ancient values which can be implemented easily today, because the world once in the way the ancient values were designed and the world today we are living is a lot different. In the same way, I like to point out to you one more example. We all know there is a plant in the seed, and we sow a seed, and the plant doesn't say that, okay, the seed is a better place, I will stay here. It doesn't stay inside, it germinates, it comes out. So is the ancient values and modern values. This ancient values is a seed, and the plant, modern values which are sitting inside that seed, cannot say, I will sit inside in the ancient times and I will not come out because this is good. No, it has to come out. For the plant to come out and give fruits to everyone, the plant has to grow. It has to develop itself into a modern value. So modern values are nothing but the modern evolution of the ancient values. So I'd like to point one more point. Swami Vivekananda's life. Before Swami Vivekananda, there was no monk who crossed Indian borders or the country borders and went to abroad. But Swamiji took up these tasks because his country needed his work, because he needed to go to the West and get the knowledge of West, get the power of West to India, because India is in dire need of that power. So he has to cross over a value, but no monk should cross the border, but he has to cross it because its situation is needing it. The condition is needing it. So modern values are nothing but the evolution of ancient values according to the condition. So today we are living in a modern world, and we needed that ancient values which have been transferred or come brought down to the modern level of modern citizen as modern values. So I conclude that for a good citizen life in today, we need modern values. Thank you.
So all these six people, three on my left, three on my right, representing the ancient values and modern values, have given their thoughts. Now we'll just give 1 minute time to the student sitting to my left, representing the modern values. Can you just clarify, what are the modern values in your opinion? Just 1 minute each. You have been telling modern values, but I want to know, as a participant, what do you have in list called modern values? So that if you can decide in 1 minute, 60 seconds, quickly. One minute time, Mutaya.
Yeah, once again. The modern values nothing but the ancient values only, which are moderated. We can say that giving a freedom, giving the equality for everybody. In olden days, we don't have equality. Everybody have their own steps, like Kshatriya, Shudra, and like that. They have a steppings. They can't go from downstate to the upstates because they have to keep up very far away. Nowadays, everybody is equal. I can give an example of that, simply. See, only the rich people only used to get education in olden days. I can say that a Hindu can go to temple. A Hindu can go to temple. A Christian can go to church. A Muslim can go to mosque. But we can't find a Christian in a temple. And knowingly or unknowingly, God is dividing within that. But a college, you know that, it makes us unite as one. A college makes us unite as one. Like in a place where we all go together. We don't have any variations here. Like here, see, the right, no time. Christian. Yeah, like I can say that, giving clarity that. The finally, just half second. With a knife, we can cut it, we can kill it. With the same knife, we can get the life also. By doing operation.
Very good.
That's.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Ms. Shabari Kumari, what are the modern values in your opinion? Oh, sorry, Sahana. Just take 60 seconds to say what are these values which you call modern. Just like Shivshankar telling, giving freedom.
Once again, for the modern values, first of all, I would like to stress on the equality of women, empowerment of women. In ancient times, there was no equality to women. Now we are getting equal rights as gents. Now, one more thing I want to stress. Swami Vivekananda ji had a great love for American nation. Now such nations, for example, America, they are dependent on India for ITs and BTs, the modern technologies. If we go with ancient values, how could we compete with such nations? How could such nations depend upon India, which is a developing nation, and America is already a developed nation? Such developed nation is depending on India just because of modern values. Thank you.
Very good. So equality of women and rights of women, one of the values. Okay. Can listen to Shravan Kumar again. 60 seconds.
I would like to take Ramakrishna order as a best example for modern values, because there is a belief, or like it's a like system where monks are restricted to only one place. They should live on alms or some begging food, and they should stay in one place or teach some students and stay back. But when I came to Ramakrishna Math, I see many of Swamiji's using laptops, presentations, showing them students what they want, and recordings and all these things. Swamiji, this is what we call modern values. You are still a monk, you preserve that value. At the same time, you are using the technology and the modernized principles. Today, I see many of the Swamiji's taking classes for entrepreneurs, managers, high class professionals, because they have modernized the principles and ideals of Swamiji to the requirement. So my point of moderation is using what we have in the ancient value, which are good, at the same time using what the technology to the proper extent.
Okay, thank you. When Shivshankar was telling giving freedom, ancient times not much of freedom was there. Now we have to give modern value is freedom. I remember a small incident which happened in Hyderabad. Some boys were throwing stones on buses and buildings during the agitation. Educated boys, modern boys. Then somebody asked them, your own building, your own buses, why are you breaking and burning them? They asked him. The boy told, Vivekananda told, you can do anything and everything, so break the buses. So Shivshankar ji, does it mean giving freedom to break buses? Considerable freedom. For what? In a progressive way, not in doing as you like. Freedom for the senses or freedom from the senses is a big question mark today. Freedom from the senses is discipline. Freedom for the senses is chaos. So we have to know what exactly is that freedom and how we utilize that freedom in our modern times with education. Now, another just point to think over, Sahana Desai. You are speaking about equality of women and rights. But the problem now is, what are the duties for women? Women duties, women rights only they talk. But what are the duties? So sometimes we fumble like on the duties and forget them. The duties of a mother, Vivekananda tells beautifully, I am blessed to be born to that great mother who meditated for me for 12 years. I am blessed to be born. What I am today is because of my mother. She lived like a Maharani, Bhuvaneshwari Devi. Tremendous freedom she had. But today, that modern life has taken away some amount of personal freedom. As somebody said in your own talks, etc., the Western culture, Western values, a big debate also is going on. That is also a problem today. What to accept, what to reject, what to digest, what to vomit. We are in a confused situation. So as I said in the beginning, dharmo hihina pashubhis samanaha. So today, the number of suicides, number of diverse cases of people in modern times, that is increasing day by day. And like in America, one professor was telling me the other day, children are born to unwed mothers and the government has to take care of the children. Who is the mother, who is the father, they have no value. They have no concern. So equality, yes, India practiced it for a long time. Then in between, due to historical reasons, the Muslim invasions and the Portuguese and the Dutch, etc., there was some amount of restriction for them not to get lost in the ideas which they were trying to sell upon us. So there was some restriction for the women because they have to be the future mothers and parents in the country. So equality is good. Swamiji expected that. As you know, many of you, Swamiji brought Sister Nivedita from England, Miss Margaret Noble, and then he sent her to Holy Mother Sri Sharada Devi. Mother was sitting there, the embodiment of ancient culture, spirituality and purity. And Swamiji was thinking, if Holy Mother accepts Sister Nivedita, it is as good as whole India accepting Sister Nivedita. Swami Vivekananda had little hesitation in his mind whether Holy Mother will accept her or not, because she is coming from a foreign country. But Nivedita does not know Bengali, Mother does not know English. The moment Miss Margaret Noble went into Holy Mother's room, Mother herself got up, caught hold of her hand, and just like a mother kissing the child by holding the chin, she slowly brought her, made her sit by the side and talked to her very nicely. What they talked, it is not recorded. You can call it silent communication. There is no words, but the heart speaking to the heart. One was fully modern, educated, a school teacher with so much of strength and fire. The other was so simple, so inward, hardly whispering, because of mother was always wearing that parda, but tremendous shakti inside. And Swamiji is watching from the back side. The moment Sister Nivedita is accepted, mother giving her prasadam, etc., Swamiji was relieved. Oh, now mother has accepted, now the whole India will accept Sister Nivedita. That is how Vivekananda brought in the equality and the strength in the women for a greater national purpose. So our friend also, Shravan Kumar, pointed out about Ramakrishna order. Vivekananda had told the monks should go with globes, with maps, with lanterns into the villages and teach people astronomy, physics, geography. And today it is only changed. We have got laptops, iPads, internet, and thanks to Dr. T.G.K. Murthy, we can see Mars in our bedroom also. So the Ramakrishna order is a bridge between the ancient and the modern. But so far, in all the presentations by the teams, what is important is what you have not observed. You have not been able to give what exactly are the modern values. That is why I made you repeat again. Can you tell what are the modern values? What is the dharma in modern times? What is it that we have to follow that was not followed earlier or that is rejected earlier? Now, the summary of the matter is this. Vivekananda asks a question in a letter or in a writing, shall India die? It's a very, very thought-provoking writing of Swamiji. Shall India die? If that is the way, the whole world will be extinct. All morality will be extinct. All sweet-souled sympathy will be extinct. All ideality will be extinct. and in its place will reign the duality of lust and luxury as the male and female deities, money as its priest, fraud, force, competition, its ceremonies, human soul sacrificed. But such a thing can never be. Mother India will never die, because it is the eternal India. But there is a problem here. There is a big problem. In Lahore lecture, 1897, Swamiji points out the problem and the solution, which comes to the topic here. He says, this nationalship of ours, this nationalship of ours, what is this nationalship? What is this nationalship? What is this nationalship? Louder. India is the nationalship. Now imagine, Swamiji telling this whole country is a ship carrying thousands of people across the other shore, beyond misery, beyond suffering. It has plying for ages, taken millions of souls across. But today, due to your problem or somebody's problem, it matters not. This is not the time for debate. Whether it's your problem or whether it's your